In his Upanuga Bhajan Padati Sri Manasiksa, in the first verse it is stated, Guru Goshte Goshtale Su Sujane Busuragane Samantre Sinamni Brajanava Yuvadvandvashane Sadadambam Hitwakuru Ratima Purvam Atitaram Maye Swante Bratas Tatuvi Abhiyache Dhritapada. Srila Raghunath Das Goswami Pad, he's speaking to his own mind, to his own heart. He said, Oh my dear brother, I fall at your feet, and catching your feet, I beseech you with very humble words, please give up all pride, and giving up all pride, develop unflinching and unprecedented attachment for the lotus feet of Sri Guru, your spiritual master. Go stay to the places of the pastimes of Radha and Krishna Brajamandal. Go staleshu to the residence of Braj. Develop unprecedented attachment for Sujan, for the Vaishnavas, Bhusura, for the Brahmins in the Dham, Shri Shri Namni. Develop unprecedented attachment for the ones, the mantras given by Sri Guru, for the holy name, Hare Krishna Mahamantra, and for the shelter of the divine couple, Sisi, Radha and Krishna. So this is the general translation of the first verse of Manasiksha, but we should know it very, very deeply. Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur has explained each word in so many different ways. So now Srila Gurudev will explain the first verse of Manasiksha according to the commentary of Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur.
Can you explain word by word? You? What? Word by word.
Omagyanatimanandasya jnananjanashalakaya chaksuranmalitam jina tasmai sri gurave namaha. Shukadeva has ordered me to briefly give the word for word for the first verse of Manasiksha. Guru, here he begins by offering obeisance to both Diksha and Siksha Guru. Diksha Guru is one who gives Diksha mantra, and Siksha is Guru who may be same as Diksha Guru later, but who gives instruction in bhajan, in confidential bhajan. Go stay. These are the pastime places of Braj, Radha and Krishna and Braj. Literally the pasturing grounds of the cows. So of course everything takes place in this beautiful meadows of Braj. Vastala Ishu. Now we're discussing the those inhabitants of this Braj, the Brajabasis. Srila Gurudev describes those in the purports as the pure devotees of Radha and Krishna, and they're Uttam Mahabhagavats. Then, Sujane. Sujane means Vaishnavas who may not be fully attached to the worship of Radha and Krishna, Yugal Kishore, but they are in the four sampradayas, and they may reside in Vrindavan, so although they don't have the pure mood of sweet Braj, they are still to be respected, and in the purport they are described as Madhyam Adhikaris. Then, Bhusura Gane. This Bhusura means lords of the earth. Bhu, Bhumandala. Sura, the lords. So lords of the earth mean the Brahmin caste. So here they are described by Bhaktivinoda Thakur as the Kanishta Adhikaris. They may be doing so many other types of rituals, karmakandas, yagyas, different things, in Braj, not worshipping according to pure Vaishnava Tantra, but still we should respect them also. So the different levels of devotees have been described. Then he describes Swamantre. Your Diksha mantras given to you by your guru should be chanted faithfully, 3 times a day, every day, and you should know them. Srila Gurudev also has used this as an example for some some people are preaching that Diksha Mantra is not essential. But he says, if it was not essential, then why would Srila Raghunath Das Goswami say to offer unprecedented attachment for your Diksha Mantra? And then also, Sri Namni means the holy name. So this is clear, there is a distinction between one's Diksha Mantras and the holy name. And both are given honor and respect. If one chants one's Diksha Mantras carefully, then his chanting of Hari Nam will proceed very quickly to perfection. Whereas without Diksha Mantra, it may take a long time. Raja Nava Yuva Dvandva Sharane. And one should take Sharanagati. One should take complete shelter at the lotus feet of Raja Nava Yuva, the divine youthful couple. Then he says another qualification, Sadadam Vam Hitva. You should give up all false pride. This will be necessary to clear the way so you can be honoring all living entities and properly respecting all inhabitants of Braj. Sadadamam Hitva. Kuru Ratim. This means that Rati, that spiritual attachment, Kuru, you should be making intense endeavors for achieving this spiritual attachment. Apurvam Atitaram. Apurvam means unprecedented. Then he says, you should have an unprecedented spiritual attachment and making very intense endeavors to attain this. In the purport, Srila Gurudev and Srila Bhaktivinoda Thakur describe, if you're making these intense endeavors, then you'll get the mercy of Guru and Krishna. So some effort has to be made from our side. We should not count that we will be like someone getting the honorary college degree while not going to school. This is a very exceptional case. Someone like an Einstein or anyone, they may later show in life they have some sanskar from previous life to deserve all kinds of honorary degrees. But for most people, they will not get this just automatically. They will have to do some work in the college. So we will have to do some hard sadhana and bhajan. Then mercy of Guru and Vaishnavas will flow to us very well. Aisvantar Bratas. Now, this is the appeal to the mind. My dear brother, Bratas, Chaturbir, and with sweet words I'm approaching you. Please, Abhyache, I pray to you. And Dhritapadaha, I fall at your feet. Please listen to this prayer. Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Bhaktivinoda Thakur kate hain. गुरु
ओम ज्ञान तिमरंदस्य ज्ञानंजन शलाक्या चक्षुर्मिलितं येन तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः. ओम विष्णु पदाय कृष्ण प्रसाद भूतले श्रीमद् भक्ति वेदांते नारायण गोस्वामी इति नामने. आई प्रे एट द लोटस फीट ऑफ माय श्री गुरुदेव. I was out of job, not in practice of translating since long time, and abruptly has given me this job so that I may be able to translate. Srila Gurudev is explaining that very long.
First from Guru.
Yeah.
Guru.
The question was, how, which Guru? Srila Gurudev is saying, in Sanskrit there are three vachan. Ek vachan, dyu vachan, bahu vachan. In English there are a singular number and plural only, two numbers are there. But here Guru means two type of Guru has been mentioned. Not Dvivachan. Gurudev is saying that it is said Dvivachan.
Ek vachan, Dvivachan both. Both.
दो वचन है ना,
एक वचन और दो वचन दोनों. कहीं पर उनको संबोधन करते हैं तो वो
अच्छा
तब दो गुरु के ही संबंध में बात है.
सो श्रील भक्ति विनोद ठाकुर इज एक्सप्लेनिंग हियर द्विवचन टू गुरु टू टाइप ऑफ गुरु नंबर वन दीक्षा गुरु एंड नंबर टू शिक्षा गुरु. हु इज दीक्षा गुरु? हु एस्टेब्लिशेज आवर रिलेशन, हु गिव्स अस रिलेशन, हु गिव्स अस संबंध ज्ञान. He is Diksha Guru and he must be Param Bhagavat. If he is not Param Bhagavat, he cannot be a Guru. What does it mean by Param Bhagavat? Who is expert in Srimad Bhagavata? Who is expert narrator and who lives according to Srimad Bhagavatam? And then it is Shiksha Guru. Who is Shiksha Guru? Shiksha Guru is who is giving us teaching for it. He may be Diksha Guru also. Diksha Guru, who is elevated and advanced, he is giving us Shiksha. So, sometimes it happens that Shiksha Guru is more advanced than Diksha Guru. The net result is that we have to pay our full respect to both Diksha Guru and Shiksha Guru. There must not be any disobedience. We should not give up following their order. Their order should be our life and their order should be strictly followed. Then only we can realize Krishna. Srila Gurudev is explaining about himself that our Gurudev, we were having Diksha from him and also Shiksha from him. But at the same time, they were going to Pujabhad Sridhar Maharaj also, considering him as Shiksha Guru. So, I'm coming to this one. So, we have to pay our respect, similar respect, same respect. Why? Because Shiksha Guru is also of the same level. He should be anukul in accordance with our Diksha Guru. And then only we can have realization of Krishna. Full respect for Guru. From Guru, it comes the place, the abode. Gokul, ghost. What is ghost? We can call it Brajdham or we can say it Gokul. Nandgaon, Gokul, Barsana, Javat, these all places are ghost, where sweet pastimes takes place of Radha Krishna. We should do our bhajan in these places. If it is not possible physically to be in these places, that by our mind we should reside in these places and do our bhajan. Where should we do our bhajan? It is not possible for us to reside in Braj. We are living in America. We can do our bhajan in America also, USA also. But at that time, our mind should be as if we are living in this Brajdham. Srila Gurudev is saying, one thing we should note, finally, he says, finally, we have to come to this Brajdham. And we have to do this bhajan in this Brajdham. He is mentioning, suppose if we are doing our bhajan in America with full absorption, trying to absorb ourselves, our mind in Braj. But if we come really at Nandgram, Barsana, and especially Nandgram, there where so many pastimes have taken place. There is Udhav Kyari, there is Pavan Sarovar, so many other places of pastime. Our Acharyas have come to these places. They have performed their bhajan at these places. Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, he is paying his obeisances to all the Vaishnavas and to all these places. So, at present, By our mind we should try to reside in these places with this keen desire that finally we will come there, we will go there and do our bhajan. If we will come to these places, then pastime will manifest in our heart. This is the potency of this place. Srila Gurudev is again emphasizing the place Nandagram, where Srila Roop Goswami, Srila Narasanathana Goswami, they were doing their bhajan. And Gopal Bhatt Goswami also, he came and he situated himself to a nearby place at Sanket. Therefore, if we want that Krishna pastime should manifest in our heart, we have to come to these places. Ghost. This ghost is called Braj or Gokul. Then comes Parikars. All those Brijvasis, who are Brijvasis? Srila Gurudev is explaining. Those who are associates of Radha Krishna, they are Brijvasis. Everyone who is living in Braj is not Brijvasi. Those who are Rupanuga, they are Brijvasi. We have to give our life and soul to them. Full respect. Full love to them. To whom? To Brijvasis, who are Rupanuga, who are associates of Radha and Krishna. So all bhakta, bhakta matra, we have to give our respect. Who is bhakta? Srila Gurudev is explaining. Ananya bhav se jo bhakti karte, who are one-pointed devotees. Those who have given up even a desire for Vaikuntha and liberation, they are true bhakta. We have to give our full respect to them. Those who have little material desire, are they bhakt? No. What to speak of material desire? Those who don't even desire for mukti, those who do not desire even for opulence of Vaikuntha dham, they are real bhakta. We have to give full respect to them. Ekantik bhakti hi brajvasi hai. So such one-pointed devotees are called brajvasi. How should we pay our respect? Giving up our dumb, our vanity, proud. What is the proud? Pride. What is the pride? That I know. My knowledge is great. I know so many scriptures. Give up this thought. Give up this pride. And then only we can respect to Brajvasis and Brajdham. That is why Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, he used to pay 1,000 obeisances to Brajvasis and to Brajdham. And Srila Gurudev is saying that this has started the tradition of Dandavati Parikrama. Sometimes we go in Govardhan and we see that so many people are doing Dandavati Parikrama with so many stones in with them. At one place they are paying obeisances 1,808 times with those stones. And this type of tradition came from Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, who used to give every day 1,000 obeisances to Brajvasis and Brajdham. So, can we do our bhajan in this fashion? Very difficult. We are doing bhajan with so much opulence and facilities and comfort. They gave up to full comfort. It is not possible for us to do bhajan in that strong manner, giving up our all facilities. Srila Raghunath Das Goswami, he gave up eating everything, he was just taking matha, churned buttermilk. And not in a good quantity, that also one leaf cup, that's all. This was his strong bhajan. And
Hare Krishna. अच्छा मैं जोर से बोल रहा हूँ सुनने के लिए. So, are we doing भजन?
No.
Maybe भजना भास. And may not that also. In this so much comfort, how much we are doing real bhajan? No
question of bhajan. Even it is not bhajanabhas. But we should desire for it. Then it comes sujan. Who are sujan? Those who are living in Braj but not in the mood of Brajvasi. They belong to different sampradaya. And also
in a brief folio, generally.
And also so many sampradaya lines. They are Bhusargana. But Srila Gurudev is explaining, they are not a worshipper of other demigods. They are Krishna devotee, but they are not one-pointed and not so much staunch devotee. We have to give our respect to them. They are Kanishth Bhagavat. It is not mentioned as Vaishnava also. Srila Gurudev is saying they are called as Kanishth Bhagavat. So, should you ask him?
Huh?
Oh,
it has been given. Rup Sanatan or Mahabhagavat and Sujan Madhyam Bhagavat. Kanishtha Bhagavat. Bhagavat, not Vaishnav. Because all are bhakta. But Nanda Baba and his associates, all are Mahabhagavat. Rupa Goswami, Raghunath Goswami, Sanatana Goswami, all are Mahabhagavat. And for Nimbark Ramanuj, they have been told Madhyam Bhagavat. They are Bhagavat. Why not? Because they don't accept Unnatu Jalpartiya Bhav. And third, more lower, Sujan. Bhusur. Brahmin. Why Brahman? They are bhajan parai, but not ekantik. They don't know what is unnatu jalpartiya bhav or bhajan like Ramanuj, Madhvacharya, Vaishnava, like that. But well, they are Brahmin and they follow Vaishnava, Varnashram Dharma. But they should be given respect. They may do. They do also, Krishna also. They may see that Gopishwar Mahadev, Krishna are same. Udhar kaya to bhojan ko Mahabhagavatar matur samband diya jabe na. Anshik samband diye.
In case of Brahman, we should not disrespect them. Even Brahmans are chastising us or sometimes scolding us. Srila Gurudev is quoting from Srimad Bhagavatam. We should not consider them that they are doing any chastising to us and we should disrespect them. We should bear their chastisation.
But and they were Atri, Vibhasa, Narad, all like these.
These Brahmans are of the category Srila Gurudev has explained, like Durvasa Rishi, Atri Rishi, Angira Rishi, etc. Naradji. We should not misbehave.
There are so many Brahmins in Braja. They don't keep tilak, no bhajan, doing business here and there. We should not respect them. But as a person, we can give honor in this way.
Then comes our own mantra, so mantra. We should not do chant this mantra in a neutral mood. Oh, we are chanting Hari Nam. It is so great. This mantra is not so much powerful. No, we should have full faith in it and full enthusiasm for this mantra. Because this mantra gives us a relationship. Gopal mantra, he takes us up to Golok Vrindavan. And what about Kam Gayatri? What is Kam Gayatri? It is Krishna's Savroop. And Krishna is worshipped by this mantra. It is already explained by in Chaitanya Charitamrita.
So, चित्त को चंचल करके मत भजते मंत्र जप करो, चित्त को स्थिर रखो. अभी जाना है, अभी जाना है, अभी ये करना है, अभी वो करना है. मन चंचल है, जल्दी से कर दिया, ऐसा नहीं. मन को स्थिर करके प्रीति के सहित में भजन करो, वो मंत्रों का स्मरण करो. हाँ, तो वैसे ही मंत्र कर बैठते थे तो समाहित हो करके करते थे, ऐसे चंचल चित्त नहीं.
So while chanting our mantra, we should be very much fixed up, not by flickering minded. Or, oh, I have to do this, I have to do this, let me finish my mantra quickly. So restlessly chanting mantra will not give any effect. And then come Harinam. This Hare Krishna Maha Mantra, we should chant very, very dedicatedly. At least we should chant 1,64,000 rounds. And one is engaged in some services, then he may reduce some number of chanting. Because such high class of service is also a sort of Harinam. Seva. Therefore, seva is very essential, Srila Gurudev is explaining. If we are not rendering our service, we cannot cultivate even Sukriti. And without Sukriti, we cannot advance in Krishna consciousness. In which mood we should chant? Radhika Dasi Yadi Hai Abhiman. We should have this mood that we are servitor of Srimati Radharani. Then we should chant by giving up our all hypocritic mood. Kapatta. What is kapatta? Having any material desire. This will make our mind, our heart hypocrite. This will make our mind insincere, kapat. Therefore, sincerity comes when we throw away all our material desires. This will lead to ekantik bhav, one-pointed mood. And then rati will come. The name of this rati, Srila Gurudev is saying, apurva rati. What is apurva rati? This love in our heart, it will come when our all unwanted desires go away. This situation has to be attained. Any Kanishth Vaishnava, he cannot have such type of mood and feeling. So we have to first give up our all unwanted desires. So this rati is very top, high class of thing. It starts from shraddha and goes to nistha, then ruchi, asakti, and then this rati comes. This rati comes in the true constitutional position. Unless one attains the true constitutional position, this rati does not come. Therefore, if we want to attain that constitutional position and that rati, we have to follow all these rules which has been narrated here. We have to take shelter of Atma Rati. We should not take shelter of our fate. Oh, if we will be having in our luck, then we will be doing it. Otherwise we should wait for. No, for this we should endeavor hard. As much as we will do bhajan, that will increase our internal potency, that will give us potency. Bhajan.
बस 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 बहुत हो गया.
एक प्रश्न किया दीक्षा गुरु से, शिक्षा गुरु का वैशिष्ट्य क्यों है? दीक्षा गुरु और शिक्षा गुरु बराबर ही हैं,
If it is said sometimes Shiksha Guru is superior to Diksha Guru, why? Srila Gurudev is explaining, Diksha Guru is like father. We have to show our reverence, honor.
Ashwarji mood or honor to him.
Honor to him. So we have that Ashwari mood for him. And Shiksha Guru is friendly with us. He is Bandhu. We can go more deep for, and we can reveal our heart to him. Therefore sometimes Shiksha Guru is... Therefore it is said sometimes Shiksha Guru is superior. And it may be possible that if Diksha Guru and Shiksha Guru may be same also. Lord Premanande.
This morning the devotees will receive
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Namo Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Krishna's sister that his killer, his would-be killer, had been born elsewhere. So Krishna sent his demons to kill all baby boys, but he said, any small girls, Kansa said, that any small boys should be killed, any small girls you should bring to me, because he knew that the eternal consort of Krishna would be born. So Putana came, and she found baby Radhika, picked her up, and began to fly. But then Vridachal brought a priest who began to chant mantras to kill the abductor of Shivani Radhika. Then Putana became very, very alarmed, and she dropped Radhika, and she fell by Yogamaya's arrangement here. So, Rishikant.
आजकल का
5,000 पर
का बनाया हुआ बनाया हुआ
We're starting in 2 minutes. Ready, ball!
Thank you.
Krishna has beautiful curly locks. And Yashoda also has very long, beautiful, dark, curly locks.
एक समय में यहाँ कृष्ण खेल रहे थे बच्चों के साथ में doing kartali, clapping their hands and so much. Oh, they were laughing. Krishna told them, why you are laughing? I am clapping. And then Krishna told, and then Baldev Prabhu told, Arnab Mangal told, oh, your mother is fair complexion. Your father is fair complexion. But how you can play? You are not son of Yashoda and Nanda Baba. Anyone else? And they kept it in a tree.
Tip of the tree.
And then Nanda Baba found it weeping you and took it to Yashoda. Sariyali was upset. Krishna began to weep very bitterly and went to mother. And she was not sitting in the lap of Mother Yashoda. Mother Yashoda told, why you are weeping? Tell me, I am not your son. All are standing like this and clapping. Then Mother Yashoda told her, no. By Sapatha. Of Naran Salagram, that is your permission. Yes. And then Krishna was satisfied. So yes.
Hare Krishna. Yamuna Arjun Dharua hai. So Dakshin Ami mein yahan par chalte Yamuna kinare par. They have one artifact here, which they sent from the original grinding mortar, which on this side where everyone is circumambulating.
Yeah.
palace of Nanda Maharaj. You know that the cowherd people, the Brij Vasis, they were not stationary in one place. During Krishna's pastimes, the Brij Vasis, both before his appearance and during his period in Vrindavan, they were nomadic people, they were cowherd people. And they would go from one place of Braj to another place so that they could find new grasses, fresh new grasses for their cows. Because as you heard, they had many, many lakhs and lakhs and lakhs of cows. So their main interest was to be in a place for grazing their cows. And so also the father of Nanda Maharaj was named Parajanya. Parajanya Maharaj, he was the king of the cowherd people at that time. And he had five sons and two daughters. The middle son was Nanda. So all of the sons and the daughters, they had children, but only Nanda did not have any offspring. And this is a cause of great concern to Parajanya. So Parajanya, he did austerities and penances. Austerities were done by Ashishwara Mahadev, and he received blessings from Mahadevji, and that he would receive a very beautiful son. So, the pastime of Krishna's birth occurred here, in this very place. Now we have read from Srimad Bhagavatam, the narration of Krishna's birth as explained by Shukadeva Goswami, that he took birth as the son of Vasudev and Devaki in the jail of the palace of King Kamsa. So our Vaishnava charges have explained that actually Krishna is eternally the son of Mother Yashoda and Nanda Maharaj. It is not that they are his foster parents, that only he was brought here by his real parents and left in the care for some time temporarily and then returned. This is not the correct Siddhanta. Only those who are the Mathura Vasis, they will believe this Siddhanta, that Krishna is the son of Vasudeva Devaki. But those who are the Brij Vasis, why they don't believe it? Because in this very place, with their very own eyes, they saw that Krishna emerged from the womb of Mother Yashoda, and they also witnessed the umbilical cord cutting ceremony. So if you try to tell a Brij Vasi that Krishna is the son of Vasudeva, they will simply laugh. They will not believe. But there are some very deep siddhants. Because, actually, it is true, Krishna took birth in the palace of the jail house of Kamsa. But that appearance of Krishna is not the eternal, the original Ishvara Parama Krishna Sachidananda Vigraha Anadir Adir Govinda Sarva Karana Karana. That is not the original supreme Bhagavan Swayam Krishna. But that is his expansion, Vasudev Krishna. Oh, and he became very concerned, and when the waters came up to his neck, then suddenly Krishna, he dangled his feet down into the waters, so that the human being could embrace him. And then the waters receded down, and then at that time Krishna came across the river Jamuna. But actually the acharyas have also explained that when Krishna came to Gokul here, Mother Yashoda was completely asleep, because after giving birth, childbirth, she was exhausted, and she was completely asleep by the arrangement of Yogamaya. No one saw him come and enter. And at that time, when he brought the baby Krishna in his arms, Vasudeva Krishna, then he did not notice that the original Nanda Nanda, usurped Nanda Krishna, was also there. And by the Argonian charges, that Krishna is eternally the son of Nanda and Yashoda. There is no other Siddhanta than this. And all of the other expansions of Krishna, and all of the other pastimes, such as killing the demons, and subduing all the different types of demoniac elements in the world, with that removing the burden from the earth, this was all performed by Vasudeva Krishna. Thank you.
Savaki is no other than his own form. Pujipad, his Maharaj was saying that Krishna and Vasudev, they are one and the same, only the difference of complexion. But here in the temple, we are seeing he is black. So, Dauji, his own complexion is fair complexion, but here we are seeing he is black. When Krishna was in Dwarka, then Balaram Prabhu came here to pacify Vrijavasis, and then he saw the deep mood of separation of Gopi. He could not tolerate it. He moved with them. He also got absorbed in the mood of separation with Krishna, as much as that his complexion turned as that.
मुझे भी करनी है।
हाँ बढ़िया।
Work of Guru is to replace the living entities who are fallen in this world, material world. Back to eternal abode in the form of Guru. And thus, Baldev Prabhu is accompanied to them. This place is the root and origin of the Akhand Guru Lata, because this is the place where Dauji Balaram is living. He was born here, he stayed here, he lived here. One thing is there, I want to share my feelings with all of you.
Thank you.